So the first question we need to answer for any problem is, what are the inputs? For this problem, they're fairly clearly stated. So it's given your birthday and the current date. Well, that's the input to the problem. What's the set of inputs we really want this to work for? Should it really just work for my birthday and today's current date? If that's all we want it to work for, well, then we can figure this out once. We don't actually need to write a procedure. So I think what is really intended by this is something much more general. So the inputs are really two dates, and that gives us the type of input. That gives us a set of all possible inputs. We need to think a little more carefully to know if they're all valid. Well, the statement of the question gives us a good clue here. It said, assume that the birthday and the current date are correct dates, and no time travel. This probably is a valid assumption if we're talking about birthdays and current dates. If we're comparing any two dates, well, this says that the second date needs to be after the first one. Assumptions like this make life easier for programmers. They mean it's easier to write our code since it has to work for fewer possible inputs. I like the way Mateus stated this as no time travel. For a program specification, we probably want to be a little more precise and just state simply, the second date must not be before the first date. And if we're being good defensive programmers, we should check this is true. It's an assumption. It's up to the user of our code to satisfy this because we've said, well, that's a requirement. To use our solution, you have to make sure the second date is not before the first date. But if we're going to be smart, we're going to program in a more defensive way because sometimes other people might make mistakes or we might make mistakes, and we're actually going to check this in our code. The other assumption we might want is something about the range of dates. Calendars are very complicated, and they've changed over history. We're going to require that the dates are valid dates in the Gregorian calendar, which started in October 1582. Our code will probably work for dates outside this range, but it might not get exactly the right answer, since when the calendar changed, the meaning of dates changed.